name is Nabil. I'm from 8th grade at Sekolah Indonesia Yangon. Today I'm gonna tell you about a story of the clever mouse deer. This is a mouse deer. Mouse deer in Indonesia language is called Sangkancil. The story of Sangkancil is a series of traditional fables about clever mouse deer. The story is very popular in Indonesia and Malaysia. Sangkancil uses his intelligence to trick over the other animals to escape from trouble. One day, Sangkancil was walking in the field. La 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 la. I wonder what I'm gonna do today. Then he saw some vegetables and went to eat them. Ooh, vegetables. There's so many and they look so delicious. I'm very hungry. Maybe I'll eat them. Suddenly, his foot was stuck at the far scarecrow's body, which has been filled with glue. Oh no, I'm stuck. My foot is stuck. I can't get out. He tried to pull his leg out. Suddenly, a farmer saw Sangkancil and caught him. Hey, what are you doing eating my vegetables? Get back here, I'm gonna catch you. He put Sangkancil into a coop because he wanted to cook him for dinner. Stay there, don't go anywhere. He tried. Sangkancil wanted to run away, but he couldn't. Suddenly, there was the cat, farmer's cat. So he tried to trick the farmer's cat. He told the cat, I'm just resting here. The farmer's cooking a meal for me. The cat believed him. She was very angry because the farmer had never cooked her a meal. Sangkancil told the cat to exchange places with him so he could eat the meal. The cat agreed. The cat opened the coop and Sangkancil escaped. When the farmer came back, he was very angry and he punished the cat. Moral of the story: don't trust anyone blindly. Most people you meet are with you for their own sake and interest. That's all from me. Thank you for watching. Bye.
Hello, my name is Fakhriano Fadri, and I'm from grade 8, Cutnyakdin. I'm from Sekolah Indonesia Yangon, and today I'm going to present to you, or maybe tell you a story about a colonel, a military colonel named Igusti Ngurah Rai. Igusti Ngurah Rai was born in the village of Carangsari Evening, Badung Regency, Bali. He was born in January 30, 1917, died in Marga, Tabanan, Bali, Indonesia, 20th November 1946, at the age of 29 years old. Igusti Ngurah Rai is an Indonesian hero, national hero, who of Badung Regency, Bali. Igusti Ngurah Rai had a force that named Ciung Narang. Let's go, guys, move. Okay, so during the final battle known as Puputang Margarana, he and 1,372 members of Fighter MBO, okay, don't lose, Headquarters Umum Council of the Republic of Indonesia Perjuangan Besar Sunda, PPRI SK. Monument complex made tombstone at Sunda A. London Declan, Temple Marga Tamanan, detailed struggle Igusti Ngurah Rai and CW Regiment can be seen in several books, such as Guerrilla Together. And also, I believe the book was named People Around Mr. Rai. And also, in 1993, the book called People Around Mr. Rai was wins the award known as Grace Harkitnas Journalism in 1993. Story of the Friends of the... Okay, so the book was actually named People Around Mr. Rai, The Story of the Friends of the National Hero Brigadier General. Igusti Ngurah Rai, or the book Popotan Margarana, date 20 November 1946, compiled by Wayan Jugug Giri. The Indonesian government conferred Mahaputra Star and promoted to Brigadier General. His name was later immortalized and became the National Airport for Bali. International Airport for Bali. Igusti Ngurah Rai is a national hero origin Bali, who died in a fierce battle against the Dutch. The battle is known by the term Puputan Margarana. He was born in Badung Regency, Sari Charang, January 30, 1913, and died 20 November 1946, and then buried in the temple Tabanan Marga, Bali. His father was named Igusti Ngurah Trench, who is a foreign district level physician. After completing his education at Denpasar and in Malang, thank you. In 1936, he continued in education at the School of Military Letters in Gianyar Bali. And I want to be a military. Yes, that's why I'm quoting like this. Furthermore, enrolled in Reserve Corps, Operating Officer, also known as Choro, Magelang during the Japanese occupation. Ngurah Rai worked as an intelligence analyst in Bali and Lombok. After independence, the government of Indonesia, Igusti Ngurah Rai formed the Sunda Takayar Pacildam. He became commanding officer with the rank colonel, lieutenant. Ngurah Rai then go to Yogyakarta to consolidate and get direction from the leadership of TKR. Okay, so what are we going to do now? Okay, so let's fight the touch. Returning from Yogyakarta, Bali was already occupied by the Netherlands. Igusti Ngurah Rai then formed his troop, then I said before, Tiung Unara. After that, they do a raid on the Dutch position in the village of Marga Tawanan, Bali. Dutch land launched a massive attack by land and air. Yes, what a cheater, like, right? Okay, so this is this. Hey, just pretend that this is a Dutch. Hey, we need backup. Let's just send some backup from air and land. In honor of his service, the government of Indonesia gave him the title of National Hero by Presidential Decree Number 63, DK 1975, dated August 9th, 1975. And that's the end of the story of Igusti Ngurah Rai, a hero that was born in a famous country, a famous city, but no one really knows who he is, because no one even cares about him in the foreign world. Thank you so much. Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.
Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.
Hello, my name is Fauzan. I'm from grade 8, Cok Nyak Din. Today I'm gonna tell you about all the information for now that I know about Gatot Subroto. Gatot Subroto was born in Purwokerto, Central Java. He began his education at Europe's Lagere School, an elementary school for the children of the Europeans, but was expelled for fighting with Dutch. He then moved to Holland's inland school for Indonesians. He did not continue his education after graduating from this elementary school, but instead found a job. However, he did not like this. And decided on a military career. In 1923, Gotthard enrolled in military school in Magelang. After graduating, he joined the Royal Dutch East Indies Army, or RNEL, and rose to the rank of sergeant. In 1942, the Japanese invaded the Dutch East Indies, and Gotthard joined the PEPA, Defenders of the Fatherland, an army set up by the Japanese in case of invasion by the Allies. He received training in Bogor and was appointed commander of a company in Banyumas, then a battalion commander. Gatot was one of the group of ex-KNEL NCOs, KNEL NCOs which included future President Soeharto and future Army Chief of Staff Ahmad Yani, who joined the BKR, People's Security Agency. The forerunner of the Indonesian Army as soon as it was set up after the Indonesian Declaration of Independence Day on 17th of August 1945. On 5 November 1946, he was appointed commander of the 2nd Gunung Jati Division in Central Java. On 31st May 1948, he became commander of the military police and later that year military governor of the Surakarta Semarang Pati Madiun region. He was involved in the suppression of the 1948 Madiun Revolt. In July 1949, he went to Yogyakarta shortly after Army Commander Sudirman's return to the city, which at the time was the capital. There he was sick and had to be treated at the Panti Rapih Hospital. On 3rd August 1949, President Soekarno announced a ceasefire with the Dutch and Assumption Commander of the Java Military Territory, decided a reorganization of divisions was needed to face the threat of the possible third Dutch police action. Central Java's 3rd and 4th Division, 4th Division were merged, and Gatot Soebroto appointed commander, although he was still in hospital at the time. He was officially inaugurated on 20 November as commander of the renamed 3rd Diponegoro Division, which became the fourth division of Diponegoro military territory in December. In this capacity, he issued a warning to one of his brigade commanders, Soeharto over the establishment of the transport enterprise of using army vehicles, which the future president had set up to provide jobs for veterans. In March 1952, Gatot moved to Makassar to take over command of the 7th Division of Wirabuana military territory, which covered all of Indonesia east of Java and Kalimantan. However, on 16 November, he was arrested and displaced by his chief of staff, Lieutenant Colonel J.F. Waro. This was one of a series of small-scale coups against officer blamed for the involvement in the 17th October 1952 incident where troops demonstrated in front of the presidential palace in Jakarta calling for the dissolution of the legislature. Although Gatot supported the demonstration, he was not present in Jakarta at the time. He was subsequently either placed on non-active status as a result of incident or resigned from the military. On 20th May, he attended a mission meeting led by Nasution. Also, also inactive into West Java, which it was decided to establish a political party to fight for the return to the spirit of the 1945 constitution. The party was called the League of Supporters of Indonesian Independence, IPKI. The party won 4 seats in the 1965 election, and Gatot Subroto became a member of the Indonesian legislature representing Central Java. As soon after the election, the cabinet and the army began the process of appointing an army chief of staff to replace the acting head colonel who had not officially been installed. Gatot Subroto emerged as a compromise candidate. He turned down the job as he was worried about being manipulated by other officers. He told the cabinet that if they want a high quality officer, they should recall Nasution to the post. Nasution was officially reappointed on 7 November 1955. In the following year, Gatot Subroto was appointed deputy chief of staff, a position he held until his death. 1959, together with Nasution, he called a special meeting of the major political parties at the time to persuade them to support the proposal to return to the 1945 constitution, which had been abrogated in favor of the provisional constitution of 1950, 9 years before. All parties eventually agreed on 5th of November 1959, the 1945 constitution was reimposed by presidential decree. Later that year, Nasution and Gatot Subroto desired against taking further action against Soeharto, and after his dismissal from the command of the Diponegoro division, following revelations of involvement in smuggling, Gatot Subroto died suddenly in Jakarta on 11th June 1962 and was buried with Buddhist funeral ceremony in the village of Kalirejo, Urang Ungaran, near Semarang. A week later, he was declared a national hero via presidential decision, number 22, 1962. Wassalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.